And now we're going to hear from Reverend Sherill Clontz, and she's going to talk with us some about fresh expressions. You heard Richard Hunter reference fresh expressions. And so, Sherill, we look forward to you hearing or you sharing with us.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Oh, y'all are ready to go, aren't you? It's so nice to be able to talk to y'all about something besides standing rules. Anyway, Eugene Peterson in the 14th verse of the first chapter of John translates this way: the word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. For me, the incarnation, the fact that God so loved the world that he took on flesh and came to us, didn't wait for us to come to him, but came to us and moved into our neighborhood with all its messiness and all its brokenness. That incarnation is not only the heart of the gospel, but it is the heart of the mission of the church. In the past, though, we could simply move into a neighborhood, put up a sign, and if the preaching was good and the programs were good, people would just come to us. They would come to us in the times of crisis. They would come to us because they wanted a faith community to raise their children. They would come to us to experience God. But times have changed. Recent polls indicate that while people today are actually more interested in spirituality than they used to be, and while when I was born, very few people experienced, according to them, transformative spiritual experiences, and more people are doing them now, but they don't look to the church for those experiences. And yet we know that what they don't know is that they need a relationship with Jesus Christ. We know that this broken world needs the love and grace of Christ, that sinners need forgiveness, that the lost need to be found, that those who are in darkness need to find the light. And we want them to experience the fullness of the gospel, forgiveness for their sins, hope for the future, and also hope for all creation. Fresh Expressions is one way to move out of the walls of the church and into our neighborhoods and to incarnate the gospel of Jesus Christ for them. It's a movement that began in the Church of England and has spread to the United States. It's officially defined as a form of church for our changing culture, established primarily for the benefit of people who are not yet members of any church. And the beauty of this movement is that it begins by developing relationships. It begins with developing relationships with the people of your community. And we've talked a lot about being a learning church, and one of the ways we learn is by listening. And Fresh Expressions encourages us to listen to the needs and desires of our communities. Because Fresh Expressions of church are deeply contextual, the forms of it will be as varied as the communities that birth them. A fresh expression might meet in a coffee shop or in a truck stop. It might meet in a park, an apartment clubhouse, a golf course, a ball field, or even a restaurant. But what sets that apart from any of our other small groups is their birth with five main goals. One, to reach people who do not currently attend church. Secondly, to find appropriate ways of reaching people who may not be comfortable with our current ministry settings. Thus, fresh expressions are often birthed out of affinity groups among people outside the walls of our church, not for our own church members. To form disciples of Jesus Christ, they are discipling communities. The purpose is to become a mature group, a group that worships, that celebrates sacraments, that gives and serves together. Now, none of those elements may look anything like what we currently experience in our worship, but that is the goal, to be a functioning, worshiping, and serving congregation. And finally, they have the goal to multiply. Hopefully, fresh expressions of the church will birth new expressions of the church and share the gospel with yet more people. There's a whole lot more to be said about it and a lot more to be explored and experienced. And if you want more information, talk to Bob Alford. I think there's also a table out in the hall where you can get more information. But what I will say about it is I think this is an exciting opportunity to help our churches move outside the walls and to develop deep, intentional relationships with people who do not yet know Jesus Christ and who may never feel comfortable entering the walls of our church. And so I'm very excited about this opportunity, and I hope that your churches will look into it. Thank you.